Welcome back to my channel, and today I'm going to give my quick take on Vikram Vedha. I believe that's how you pronounce it. I'm not sure. But so this is a Bollywood film, and before I get into it, let me just give you the quick synopsis, and this comes from AMC. Vikram Vedha is an action thriller showcasing the face-off between a tough cop, Vikram, and a dreaded gangster, Vedha. The film underlines between good and evil. What you choose defines you. So like I said, this is a Bollywood film, and I believe it's the first one I've seen. It's definitely the first one I've seen in a theater. So yeah, so that's for sure. So this is a Hindi language film, and it's basically a remake of the same name from Tamil. It was done before in another language. Let's just say that. So yeah. So they, you know, it's redone, but in with the Hindi language. So yeah, there you go. So basically, all right, before I could really get into it, did I like the film? It was okay. It was all right. It's a little over the top. It honestly felt like an extended music video, right? Like the way it was shot, just a lot of the scenes were like it was just so many cutscenes, like boom, 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 right? And it was like there weren't enough like continuous. I don't know. It's just. It seemed off to me. So, you know, what I'm curious though is to watch other Bollywood films and see if there's like a certain DNA, certain trait that a lot of these films have, or is each one like completely different, right? I don't know. So I don't know if there's like a certain what's that word I'm looking for? Like a formula. Is there like a formula to these films, or because I don't know. Like I said, I haven't watched these films, so I'm not too sure. But I'm curious though. I am curious. So in this film, Vikram, I believe is the one on the left. I believe. And Vedha is the one on the right. Vikram. Yeah, just watch the. That's one of the reasons I leave the synopsis on top. That way I can refer to it in case I forget. Because this brain is not all there. Oh. So Vikram. He's supposed to be like the honest cop, the by the book cop, the black and white cop, right? But. I don't really buy that because in the film where they go meet like gangsters or whatever, they kill them. They just shoot them. Like honestly, they start shooting. The cops start shooting before the other guys. So they just start. They're just murdering people. Yeah, they're bad guys. Well, at least that's what we're told. But damn. It's not like they're shooting in self-defense. They're like straight up just, they knock, you know, they barge in, right? They kick down the door and bam, bam, bam. And then what happens is like one of them didn't have a weapon after all the action takes place. So one of the bad guys, you know, that's what we're told, you know, didn't have a weapon. So what they planted a weapon. And so when they describe this guy as like, oh, the honest cop, I don't think honest cops are going to plant things. Yeah, he's justifying it in the movie that they're bad guys. So that's like the justification. But like I said, it's not really honest and by the book either. So, yeah. So that's kind of funny, but they keep referring to him as honest. So basically, the whole story is this guy, Vedha, he's like the big boss. And he's underground. So he's underground and kind of hiding. And he comes out of hiding and he gives himself up to the police. And so basically Vedha keeps telling Vikram a story. And he keeps telling, let me tell you a story. And it's always like, it's leading up to like, why he came out of hiding. And essentially what it is that the one of the people that Vikram killed in the beginning of the film, and the one that didn't have the weapon, was his little brother. So that's why. So he's coming out to basically seek revenge. So that's what it is. And this guy's character is like, he gives like the crazy eyes, like, oh, like throughout the film. But what's funny is about this film is like, these two guys like, they're like superheroes, straight up like superheroes. Like they punch somebody and the person goes flying in the air. it's kind of funny. Like they literally, like, no joke, they go flying in the air. So they're pretty much superheroes, right? And I'm curious about other Bollywood films. Like, is it the same? Like, where the stars, right? Like, especially like, I'm assuming the male stars, are they like, like the suit, like the, you know, like superheroes, like Marvel or DC or something, right? Like they literally just punch somebody and kick somebody, and they go flying, and they never really get hurt. Like they get, I think they get shot, or at least both of them do get shot. You know, they get hit with objects, they get punched, and yeah, they'll like, you know, take it and be like, oh, you know, but they just walk it off, they get, you know, or come back and just punch the other person harder. So, I enjoyed that experience of experience a Bollywood film. I do like that. You know, was it a good film? Yeah, that's debatable. For me, middle of the road film. It's entertaining. It's a long movie. It's like 2 hours and like 50, like, I think what, 2 hours and 38 minutes. So it's a long film. It really is. They even have an intermission. And what I was told is that with another, it's customary in Bollywood films to give you an intermission of 15 minutes. But here, that really doesn't happen too much. I've seen it before with the Quentin Tarantino film with the Robert Rodriguez, where they did the, Planet Terror and... I forgot the Quentin Tarantino film. The Planet Terror was the Robert Rodriguez. The Quentin Tarantino was the one where Kurt Russell is like a race car driver or like a drag racer. I don't remember the name of the film. So they did like a double feature and they did have a 15-minute intermission. So I have been to one of those. This one, when they showed the intermission on the screen, there was no 15 minutes. They just started right away. So yeah, I don't know why they, you know, I guess, I mean, it's just cheaper not to cut it out, I guess. So that's why they left it. You know, it's an interesting experience, like I said, being my first Bollywood film. The music was interesting as far as like, and one of the reasons why I said before, like, it felt like a extended version of a music video is because the music is as well. It was very, it's just at times when they would try to show them as like superheroes, they would play like this certain music, and it was very, I don't know, it was just, It was interesting. It wasn't bad. It was just interesting. I don't even know how to explain it. It was just very like EDM type of music. It's interesting. And then they did have like a Bollywood, like, you know, at least that here in the Western, you know, in the US, would, you know, when we imagine Bollywood films, like the whole dancing, right? Like the whole, you know, choreograph, right? Stuff. And there was one, and which I'm glad I saw. And it was with Vedha. Vedha was, with his little brother in the film. And one of the stories, the backstories they were given, the little brother wanted to be legit. He didn't want to do like crimes, right? He didn't want to be like his brother. But he, you know, he didn't, you know, loved his brother. And he also wanted Vedha to be legit. He wanted him get out of that the crime scene, right? And so his little brother started like a company where they would invest into other people and stuff like that. I forget how the name of it. And they said like, what's the slogan? Big investment or small investment, big smile or something like that. I don't remember. But, so when the brother, when they finally got like a big chunk of like investments to, for the, in the company, they're going to celebrate. So when they did the celebration, that's when the Bollywood, big ensemble song and choreographs, that's when it happened. So that was pretty cool. That one was, I gotta say, that one was, it was a really good scene. I really enjoyed it. Yeah, it was really cool. It was really cool for that. That was really cool. So, I did like that. But like I said, overall, the film was okay. Middle of the road. I did see a trailer though before this one that looked really good. And if it comes out here locally, I'll probably go watch it. I don't remember. I think it was the Legend of something. I don't remember the name of the full name, but it was the Legend of something, and it looked interesting. We'll see, right? I don't know. We'll see how it is. What are the downsides? And I don't know what it was. I don't know if it was with the theater or with the movie itself, but the music was really loud. Everything was really loud in this film, like too loud. It's like, instead of, you know, putting it at 10, it was put at 12, 13. It was weird because the trailers that they played before, everything they played before the movie was fine. The audio was fine. It was normal. But when the movie started, it was so loud. Not completely, but it almost had a distortion as well, because that's how loud it was, right? It's like, you know how, if you ever experienced this, like, let's say you're watching TV and you're watching a show and all of a sudden the commercials come up and it's, the audio is just completely different, right? The different level. And you're like, holy cow. And you either have to turn it down or turn it up, right? And that's what it was here. Like I said, the trailers were fine. Everything before the movie started was fine, audio-wise. It's when when the movie started, and that's when everything it blasted. I don't know if I've ever experienced that. And it was from the get-go. It wasn't like here and there. It was like from the get-go. It was like super loud. And like I said, I don't know if it was with the film, like where it was, the audio engineer just didn't do a good job, or with the theater that they set it at a level that it shouldn't be, or it could have been a combination. I don't know, but a combination, or I have no idea. But yeah, it was really loud, and that really also, you know, I'm sure it had an influence in me enjoying the film. But overall, I like that I experienced the Bollywood film. Like I said, it wasn't the best one, but for the most part, I did enjoy it. Even though it was long, I saw it after work and I thought I was going to be tired. Usually I'm tired after work, and when I see films, sometimes I doze off a little bit, and I did in this one. I was kind of surprised because when I saw how the runtime, I'm like, holy crap, I'm going to fall asleep. At least for 10, 20 minutes or 10, 15, 20 minutes. I'm like, man. But I didn't at all. At all. So maybe it's the audio as well that just kept my senses up and wouldn't let me. But yeah, I mean, I would say check it out. You know, if you've never seen a Bollywood film, I would say go for it. Go for it. It's an experience. At least try it once, you know. I would say go for it. And I think I'm going to continue. Like I said, I saw a trailer that looked really interesting. And I want to check it out. So, if it comes out in my side of my local theaters, then I'll probably check it out. So, yeah, that's my take on it. Check it out. See what you think. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, you know, feel free to give it a like. If you enjoy my content in this channel, you know, subscription. Hit the subscribe button. That would really help. You know, I'm trying to grow this channel. Hopefully this can be my future career, but we'll see. You know, it's up to you guys, right? If you guys enjoy what I give And cool. If you don't, hey, that's cool too. So, you know, thank you. And I'll see you in the next one. Have a good one.